क्लियर. व्हाट इज द सिंबल ऑफ लाइफ? ब्रेथ. व्हेन यू आर नॉट ब्रीदिंग यू आर डेड. यस और नॉट? आई हैव वन पापी टुडे इज नॉट ईटिंग एनीथिंग. ही इज क्लोज द आईज. ही इज नॉट ब्रीदिंग. व्हाट हैपेंड? You ask the doctor, doctor will say, it's dead. Understand? He is dying. Physically, this world is dying. Means no breath. That's why he is not doing anything. And here, master gives the indirectly training to you. How to die means not to take breath. It's clear. If you are breathing, you are alive. If you are not breathing, you are dead. So you don't breathe. That's why master gives that practice, pranayama. That is the chapter, second chapter. Pranayama is the training. In other words, the art of death. It's clear. Because the goal of pranayama is keval kumbhaka. Siddhi of pranayama is keval kumbhaka. No inhale, no exhale. When you will be finished this, your avinivesha, then I know nobody can kill me. If I know this, nobody can kill me, desire death when I want to be kill myself, then you cannot do more hate to anyone. Why should I do hate? Then no hate, then no attachment. If I have attachment with everyone, attachment with nothing, then ego useless. Why I keep ego if I know nobody can kill me? Then what happened? Avidya converts in vidya. Vidya is the knowledge. Avidya is no knowledge, lack of knowledge. And this vidya savimuchyati. That vidya gives the freedom. Knowledge makes you free from everything. Clear? We need that. Not only we, all the human beings need that knowledge. Those gives the freedom. Knowledge gives freedom. I want to the freedom from my poverty. I want to the freedom from my sickness. I want to the freedom for my poor things. Okay? That freedom known as, in other word, liberation, moksha. I want to be moksha. I want to be freedom from all the boundaries. In the West countries, what happened? They say, I am free. No one I have. Your mother, yes, she says she lives someone else. Okay. Your father, he leaves someone else. A brother, he leaves someone else. Sister, she leaves someone else. No one. I am alone. It means you are living like an animal. No boundary in your life. First you make the boundary. In that boundary, you are free. If he says, I don't like any limitation. Only animals can say this thing. Human cannot say. We have always some limitations, some border. We cannot cross this border. This is my border. Understand? In this border, I am free. Understand? What I do, what I should not do, I am free. So, that freedom comes free from everything. For that, master gives, in second chapter start, Astanga Yoga. That was not Ashtanga, those you are practicing. Ashtanga means eight limbs. Ashta means eight. Now Patanjali gives to create this Yogagni. That eight limbs, that eighth limb is known as Ashtanga. Clear? Not that Ashtanga, Vinyasa, those Patta by Joyce gives. That Ashtanga is Ashta, means eight. Anga, two words there. Anga means limbs. So in the beginning I tell you Ashtanga known as Raja Yoga also, Ashtanga known as Patanjali Yoga also. Clear? What is that Ashtanga? Anybody can tell me the eight limbs it knows? Most of the teachers here?
Asana, Bhakti,
Yama,
Tantra,
Niyama, Asana, Pranayama.
Those things.
Pranayama, Prutya, Hara. Because eight limbs classified in two classes. It's clear? Two groups. One is Bahiranga Yoga. Bahiranga Yoga. Outer practice. Clear? These five limbs belongs to Bahiranga Yoga. Then start Antaranga Yoga. Clear? The limbs is number 6. 8 limbs he keeps. For what? For Yogagni. Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi, these are eight limbs. Clear?
So sorry, buddy. Bahiranga Yoga, what does that mean?
Outer efforts, outer practice. Bahiranga, antaranga, internal practice, inner efforts, inner support. Clear? It's two groups, two classes there. Eight limbs in two class. Five limbs belongs to one class and three limbs belongs to another class. These eight limbs he gave. Now I want to give star marks. What I know, but I am practicing. What I know? What I practice more? In these eight limbs. I want to give the star. How much star?
Pranayama.
Asana?
Asana.
How much? No. How much star? Asana? Everybody knows. Everybody practicing. Yoga means asana. Asana means yoga. Means five star. Same as, how many people know about pranayama?
Nice.
Very less, no? How much practice? Very less. And that is correct or incorrect, it's not a matter. So pranayama I'm practicing. How can much star I can give? Two only. My God. And then, among these eight limbs, what we know? Dhyana, meditation. How much?
Three stars.
Three stars?
Meditation.
Okay.
People don't know that word.
Many knows this. Okay. And they are practicing.
Maybe four.
Asana, pranayama, meditation. It means, hey Master Patanjali, you are fool. Why you give these eight limbs? I am so intelligent, I choose according to my suitability. What is suitable for me? Leg up, do the 1 hour in morning, 1 hour in evening, asana. Some pranayama. And then after, okay, sit with closed eyes. Who knows what you are doing with closed eyes? Solving your problems, question and problem. Question and answer, and then after you walk like a statue. Hey, what happened? I did. Very good. I did meditation. Hmm? 10 years, Pandiji, I practice these three things. I am a yogi, okay? What is Yama? Yama? I don't know. What is Niyama? I don't know. Why Master Patanjali gives this? Why not they start asana first? If you like asana too much. So what is the question for the all yoga learners, yoga seekers? Why the great master Patanjali gives this sequence? Yama, Niyama, asana.
Excuse my ignorance, but it's Yama devotion? What does that mean?
I will explain everything. Each sutra by sutra. I will explain everything. We'll bring the sutra. What he says about this. What is this? Clear? Here, just my question is this. Master gives eight limbs. Among the eight limbs, yoga practitioners, suitability. And first, what Master says? First sutra, what he says? Be disciplined. Where is discipline? I broke your discipline. And 10 years I am practicing yoga and not getting anything. Hey, you are not respecting the master. You are not respectful to the master teaching. What master wants to say? You are not hearing. You are doing your according to suitable for asana, suitable for pranayama, suitable for dhyana. Yama, where lives? Niyama, what is the name? Where lives this bird? I don't know this bird. Never I saw. Okay. What is pratyahara? Not for me. Okay. What is dharana? I don't know. Samadhi? Yes, I know, but I try. I should be achieve this. This is goal. I am not reaching. Not? See. Tell me. Everest is the samadhi. Everest. Everybody wants to reach there. So for the Everest win, what you need? I want to win this Everest. What I need? Warm clothes and
discipline.
Power and discipline and okay and
food
and
a guide.
A guide. Master you need. Anna, guide is not only the guide. Guide is a master. Mm-hmm. Show the path. And we need equipments.
Desire
equipments. Desire yoga agni. I have the Everest agni. Hmm? Not yoga agni. Everest agni. I want to be rich on the Everest. How I can? This is my full desire. Okay. We need all these things. So, Yama and Niyama is your dress up. What we need? Full dress of haiku. It's clear? Suit. Snow suit. Snow boot. Snow stick. Oxygen cylinder. Mask. And one guide. It's clear? That is your Yama and Niyama. Asana is okay, tracking, I start, without your preparation without the equipment, you start to walk where? Towards the Everest. What will happen? Tell me, you are intelligent.
I know.
How many kilometers you can walk there? 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, 3 kilometer, and then after finish. Same as in yoga, failures. Yama is the self-restraint. Yama for self-control. Niyama is rules and regulations. Without that, I should not be come on this path. Those wants to do this yoga, because Master says, Atha Yoga Anushashanam, you be disciplined, and I am bringing the disciplined way of yoga practice. What I did with that discipline? To broke it. Nobody is looking you, okay? Your result is looking you.
There's a guy who hiked up Everest in his shorts and a t-shirt. You know, Wim Hof? He does like the yogic breathing though, and he like heats his body up.
Means she was preparing, yeah. Or he was preparing, no? Yeah. Without preparation, no. Okay? So our perception is here clear. Preparation is very necessary. So what is yama? What is niyama? Asana, you can be seen in books and Google Baba everywhere. Yama and Niyama, don't talk to me, I don't know about it, like this. That's why sometimes people feel yoga philosophy is very boring. Really? If you don't know how to present the yoga philosophy, then it's boring. Otherwise, it's too much interesting. What is the Yama? You write that. What is Yama? Yama is self-control, Niyama is regulations, Asana is the physical exercise, Pranayama is the breathing exercise, Pratyahara is the... No, slowly, bye, I will go. Just you, because time is complete, that's why. Pratyahara is...
What was number 2, sorry?
Niyama is regulations, rule. Asana is pose. But I will be asked, very silly question, same that, what is asana? Few days later I will ask, not today, but few days later, in 2-3 days, I will reach there, then I will ask, what is asana? Then you can be show me. Asana is different. Pratyahara is withdrawal of senses. Withdrawal of senses.
Withdrawal.
Senses. Withdrawal.
Control.
Withdrawal of senses.
Oh, withdrawal. Yeah.
Dharana is the concentration. Dhyana is the meditation. Samadhi is connection. To whom? Yourself. You reach on the top. Yuji Samadhi. Oh? Word came from there, Samadhi. Samadhi, yes. You like too much coffee, okay? And you are sitting in meditation and the smell of coffee comes. Then what is your meditation? To the coffee? Huh?
Yeah. Isn't that self-restraint?
No. Then what you will do? First to finish the coffee, then again sit. You sit in the, just after the coffee, okay. Everything is good. Okay. After 10 minutes, your girlfriend came and she touched your back. Oh, where is meditation? Sense, no control. Sense, no control. Understand? Withdrawal of senses. Sense is there, but not feeling outside.
Yeah.
so you don't even feel the trigger. It's not like I smell the coffee, but I choose to stay in meditation. I'm in meditation and I can't even smell the coffee.
The smell is there, but you're not feeling. That is absolutely concentration. What's your mind? Trying to concentrate. Absolute concentrate. How much smell is there? Okay, but you are somewhere else. It's clear? Smell is not hurting you because your senses is right now extrovert. Then your senses will be introvert. It's clear? That is the withdrawal of senses. I sit with meditation with closed eyes. I want to be connected with myself. And I like too much. Justin Bieber. Bob Marley. And that music reach in your ears. Then what happened? Where is meditation? There you start. With that music means outer world. How much Justin Bieber, what is going on? It should be come inside there. Disconnect. Withdrawal of senses. Now you understand, my dear. Yes. You understand good. So you understand this? Then sixth one come. Dharana is concentration. Dhyana is meditation. What you are practicing in your meditation? Concentration. Think about it. You are practicing dhyana or dharana. Because dhyana is a state. Practice is concentrate. And what we say is, we are practicing dhyana, meditation, we are practicing. Actually, you are practicing dharana. It's clear? You are concentrating. You are gazing. You are focusing. Not meditating. Clear? That is the difference. I will tell you sutra by sutra, all the difference, each and everything. Okay? Yama is 5, Niyama is 5. Tomorrow I will be open all 5 sutra of Yama, all 5 sutra of Niyama. Clear? And then slowly, slowly you will be go sutra by sutra. Don't worry about it. Just you keep in your mind why Master gives these 8 limbs in this sequence. How much Yama is required? How much Niyama is required? Asana not too much required. How long? Then after discussion of the asana, your concept of asana practice will change. Right now what you think about asana, I don't know. But after that, what Master Patanjali is saying, completely your concept will change. Oh, now I am not interested to hurt my body and bone and joints in the morning, in the evening. You can be, you are doing a hurting. You hurt. It's your desire. I am not ready. Why? Because I crossed this level. What is that level? Okay? Slowly, slowly it will become in practice. It will become in more knowledge about it. Okay? That is second chapter. That practice will increase that yogagni, and that yogagni will make free from your pain. It's clear? It changes the state of your mind. Change the hurdles of my life. It's clear? So, practice is this, I will tell you. Thank you.
Thank you.